So it's time for who? Mac Jones.
Mac. That guy.
Man, we saw Mac on Thursday night in his debut against the Washington football team. He actually played quite a bit. What are your takeaways from Mac?
Mac Jones overall, I mean, he looked pretty calm, you know, looked pretty consistent, didn't look like he was really off of his game, held up in the pocket well, kept his eyes down the field. And if there's one thing I can say is, you know, one thing that I did find was a little rugged about his game was the follow through and the release. I don't feel like his form is really all the way there yet, but we did see that a little bit as well at Alabama. We got a little off script because we know he's not a super mobile guy, but he did happen to scramble for a first down. So, you know, when he wants to move, he can, but he's not going to have it as your first resort. You know, don't bake on him to have any sort of presence in that factor. But I think over time he does clean up, you know, the form, like I mentioned. But then you talk about the vision, changing protection at the line, you know, being a rookie. And again, we saw him do that at Alabama, but knowing that he's still confident enough to change his protection and it was effective for New England in the preseason. Yeah. Hopefully that does carry over and you'll get a, you know, sort of a continuity, a wise guy at the quarterback position. You're not getting too much of a drop off, rather, you know, going from Brady and then Cam, who's still a very knowledgeable guy, but you were able to keep that same culture in a smart quarterback. And then, you know, at the end of the day, he's not camping on his players. I don't feel like I really see him moving his head well, and he's not just going to camp on some of those receivers like we saw at Alabama. And he didn't necessarily do that with the Tide, but he had all the reason to, because he's having these superstar receivers. Well, welcome to the NFL. Your coverage is way tighter. Yeah. So overall, Mac Jones, I think he can be a guy that can go and win you 9, 10, and 11 games behind a New England defense, but I don't think he's going to be a franchise guy. But we'll see what happens. I mean, the Patriots saw something in him, so there is promise there for the team.
Yeah, I mean, as far as a franchise guy, that's yet to be seen. Just we got to look to see how he develops. So what he looks like at this very moment is a very effective game manager. I mean, with the type of defense that we have, he's not going to be expected to play right away. I know there's a lot of folks, even Wesley, sitting there in the chat that are like, yeah, let's talk about how he's going to take Cam's job. He didn't play against the, he did not play against the first team defense. There was no Chase Young on the field when Mac Jones was playing. He went 13-19, and he only threw for 87 yards because he threw a lot of short passes. Like, he was throwing screens and slants, crossing routes. He only attempted two deep balls, one of them under pressure. He overshot his receiver. Then he threw it to Gunner. He overshot him by about a yard. Like, it was close, but he got hit as he threw it.
Yep.
The other one, he threw it in the end zone, and it was a drop. It should have actually been a touchdown.
Right.
I mean, his two attempts on the deep balls were not bad. I mean, he definitely has the presence at the line of scrimmage. To, just like you were alluding to, he changes the actual blocking schemes. He goes through progressions very well. He's just not a game-breaking quarterback.
Exactly.
Unless you get him those kind of weapons, then that's really not what he's going to be.
Right.
But he looks like he can actually come in and command an offense, so long as that's all you're asking of him. He does protect the football, so you don't have to worry about that.
Yep.
And even to his mobility, he's very slow. I mean, nobody's actually ever accused him of being a quick guy, but he has enough pocket presence where he did step up and get a little quick 2-yard first down run.
Yep.
So like, even being that slow, he understands the situation well enough to be like, I can get right there before y'all get to me.
Right.
So, I mean, he's effective enough, and he's going to have plenty of time to sit back there and groom. He's not playing this year. I've been trying to tell you guys. Y'all don't listen.
Right. Now, I agree with you.
Cam is the starter. Mac will play next year.
Yeah.
He's going to get a whole year to soak everything up and learn.
Absolutely. And you mentioned him being a game manager. He's got some of those qualities, you know, accuracy, not being afraid of the tight throws, the hesitation. And you even alluded, I think he kind of silenced the doubters with the couple of deep throws that, yes, were incomplete. But like Mac showed you, hey, if I see my targets, I'm going to let it rip, you know, yeah. And even if the coverage is tight, because the dudes weren't wide open. I respect the throws from Mac. He's got a lot of improvement to go, though.
Both of them were tightly covered.
Right.
I mean, the drop touchdown, he dropped it right in his hands.
Literally. He should have caught that. Yeah, that was a great throw from Mac Jones. And everybody was hype about that, rightfully so.
Yes, I mean, he definitely had a good debut.
Right.
I mean, there's some promise there, especially knowing that we don't have to actually watch him play week one.
Right. Shouldn't.
Absolutely not. So, yeah, man.